Hello dear friends, I am Dr. Pradab Naikwade. Welcome to your favorite channel, PVN Science Study. In this video,
in today's lecture, we are going to study classification of fungi. Dear students, fungi is very important group of plant, and here we are going to study how fungi are classified into different groups. First of all, we will study general characters of fungi. The term fungi, in plural it is called as fungi and in singular it is called as fungus. So this fungi or fungus, it is derived from the Latin word fungus, which means mushroom. Fungi can be defined as eukaryotic spore producing achlorophyllous organisms. Fungi show great diversity in morphology as well as habitat, and we can see a fungi at various places. Occurrence of fungi is universal. Fungi occur in air, water, soil, and they are also present as parasite on animals as well as plants. The vegetative structure of fungi is usually the branched filamentous hyphae having cell wall made up of chitin or cellulose or both. Now let us study what is hypha. So here in this diagram you can see this is the mycelium and this is the hypha. Hypha is long, slender, thread-like structure, and network of hypha is known as mycelium. So this is one hypha, this is second hypha, this is third hypha, and this total network of hypha is known as mycelium. This mycelium is non-vascular and it is non-motile. Hypha can be divided into two types, one it is known as synostatic hypha and another one it is asynostatic hypha. So here we can see both the type of the hyphae. This is the diagram which is showing the synostatic hyphae, and here we can see the unsynostatic or septate hyphae. Synostatic hyphae, these are the continuous tubes and they are filled with multinucleated cytoplasm. So here we can see that many nuclei are present here, and these nuclei, they are embedded within the cytoplasm. So such type of the hyphae, it is known as the synostatic hyphae. Then the next type of the hyphae, it is asynostatic or the septate hyphae. So this is the asynostatic or septate hyphae. As you can see here, the main difference between the synostatic and asynostatic hyphae, it is that here septa or cross walls are present, and due to the presence of this septa, it is called as septate hyphae. Dear students, now we will study other general characters of fungi. Fungi reproduces by three different methods. These are vegetative, sexual or asexual type of the method of reproduction. Fungi also reproduce by means of spores. No embryonic stage is observed in fungi, and they develop directly from spores. Fungi also produce pheromone which leads to sexual reproduction. Fungi also shows alternation of generation in their life cycle. That means one generation is going to alternate with the another generation. As fungi are achlorophyllous, and so therefore they cannot prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. They have to depend on other organisms or dead and decaying organic matter for their food. So fungi are heterotrophic. Heterotrophic means they are dependent on others for the food. They may be parasitic, saprophytic or symbiotic. Parasitic means fungi are living on living organisms. Saprophytic mean fungi which are growing on dead and decaying organic matter, and symbiotic is the mode of nutrition in which both host and parasite both are getting benefits. Some fungi are parasitic and they can infect the host and causes diseases to the host. Fungi can store food in form of starch. Biosynthesis of chitin is also carried out in fungi. Here you can see the typical fungal structure, where we can see the cell wall is present at the outer side. Then we can see the cell membrane, and inside cell membrane we can observe mitochondria as well as endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, Golgi apparatus as well as nucleus. So as you can see here, fungi contain very small nuclei. The study of fungi is called as mycology. Here, mycology, this word is derived from two words. One, it is mycos, meaning is mushroom, and logos means study. The person who study mycology, that is fungi, is known as mycologist. There are so many different classification given by different scientists, out of which the classification given by G.M. Smith is very much common. Some of the common examples of fungi are mushroom, as you can see here, as well as mold and yeast. Dear students, now we will see classification of fungi. Fungi are mainly divided into two groups. One division is myxomycophyta, or they are also called as slime molds. They are further divided into myxomycete, plasmodiophori, and ericae. The another division of fungi is eumycophyta, or they are also called as true fungi. The division eumycophyta or true fungi are further divided into phycomycete or algal fungi, then ascomycete or sac fungi, basidiomycete or club fungi, and deuteromycete, or they are also known as fungi imperfecta or imperfect fungi. In today's lecture, we are going to study the different classes included under true fungi. So let us study first class, that is phycomycetes. The phycomycetes are generally considered to be the most primitive type of the fungi. These fungi have morphological similarity with algae, and so therefore for a long time they were considered as algal fungi. These fungi are found in aquatic habitat, on decaying wood, and in moist and damp places. Some of member of class Phycomycete fungi are obligate parasite on plants like algae and on animals like fish and insect, and some are saprophytic. In most of the Phycomycete fungi, vegetative phase has profusely branched aseptate and multinucleated mycelium. So here you can see the structure of mucor. So here you can see the hyphae, which is aseptate and sinusitic. In class Phycomycetes, asexual reproduction mainly takes place by formation of zoospores, which are motile, or aplanospores, which are non-motile. The number of spores within a sporangium is always indefinite. The spores produced endogenously in the sporangium. So, as you can see here, this is the sporangium, and in this sporangium, spores are produced endogenously. Zygospores are formed by fusion of two gametes. The gametes may be considered as isogamous when the gametes are similar in morphology, while they are considered as unisogamous or oogamous when they are dissimilar in morphology. Some of the common examples are mucor, so this is the structure of mucor, or rhizopus. It is also commonly known as bread mold. So here you can see albugo as parasite. Then the next class is class 2 ascomycetes. So here you can see sketches of members of class ascomycetes. Members of class ascomycetes are also commonly known as sac fungi. Some of the members of class ascomycete are unicellular, such as yeast, while some of the members of class ascomycete are multicellular, and common example it is the penicillium. Penicillium is multicellular, as you can see here. These fungi are saprophytic, decomposers, as well as parasitic or coprophilous. That means these are growing on dung. In ascomycetes member, the mycelium is branched and septate. As you can see here, conidia are produced by the members of class ascomycetes. These conidia are the asexual spores produced exogenously on special mycelium, that is the conidiophore. So this is the conidiophore, and on this conidiophore, the conidia are produced. These conidia on germination produce fungal mycelium. Ascospores are the sexual spores produced endogenously in sac like asci. So here you can see the ascus, and inside ascus, ascospores are produced. Here you can observe that 8 ascospores are present inside one ascus. When it is single or singular, it is known as ascus, and when they are many, that is plural, they are known as asci. Ascocarps are the different types of fruiting bodies in which asci are arranged. Some members of class Ascomycetes, such as morels as well as buffels, they are edible. That means we can eat morels and buffels. Some of the common examples of Ascomycetes are Aspergillus. So this is Aspergillus. Then the second one, it is the Claviceps. So this Claviceps is causing disease, ergot operi. Then the next example, it is Neurospora. So here you can see Neurospora. Then let's study class 3, that is Basidiomycetes. Here you can see some of the members of Basidiomycetes. Common forms of Basidiomycetes are mushroom, or they are also known as bracket fungi or pup balls. Basidiomycetes grow on soil, on logs, as well as tree stumps. Some of the members of Basidiomycetes, they also grow on living plant bodies as parasite, and they are causing diseases such as rusts as well as smut to the crops. So here you can see the rust of wheat. In Basidiomycetes, the mycelium is branched and septate. In Basidiomycetes, the asexual spores are generally not found. Here, vegetative reproduction takes place by process of fragmentation. Fragmentation, it is the process in which the mycelium is cut into small fragments, and later on, each fragment is developed into the fungal mycelium. In Basidiomycetes, sex organs are absent, but two important processes takes place. These are plasmogamy and karyogamy. Plasmogamy is the fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strains or genotypes, and resultant structure, it is dikaryotic, which ultimately gives rise to basidium. And karyogamy is fusion of two nuclei. Here karyon means nucleus. Karyogamy and meiosis takes place in the basidium, producing 4 basidiospores. As the name of the class is Basidiomycetes, here basidiocarps are produced. These are the fruiting bodies in which basidia are arranged. Some of the common examples of Basidiomycetes are Agaricus. So this is the figure of Agaricus. It is also commonly known as mushroom, which is edible in nature. You might have tasted it. Then the second one, it is the Ustilago. It is causing smut disease to the plants, such as smut of maize. And another example, it is the Puccinia. Puccinia is causing rust disease to the wheat and other plants. Now we will study class 4, that is Deuteromycetes. And here you can see some of the examples of members of Deuteromycetes. The members of Deuteromycetes are commonly known as imperfect fungi, because here sexual reproduction is absent and only the asexual or the vegetative phases are observed. Once perfect sexual stages of members of Deuteromycetes were discovered, then they were moved to Ascomycetes and Basidiomycetes. The members of Deuteromycetes reproduce only by asexual spore, that is Conidia. So here you can see Conidia. As you can see here, the mycelium is septate and branched. Some of the members of Basidiomycetes are saprophytes or parasites. Many members of Deuteromycetes are decomposers of leaf litter, and they help in the mineral cycling, and they are helping in the decomposition of the organic matter. Some of the common examples of class Deuteromycetes is Alternaria. So this is Alternaria. Then this is the figure of Coleotrichum, and this is the Trichoderma. So dear students, with this we have completed the classification of fungi. Thank you.